right now, there are winter storm warnings all up and down the coast. There are winter storm watches in areas that don't have a warning right now, and those will likely be upgraded to at least an advisory tomorrow. But you get the idea. That area that you see kind of in the pinkish color there, that is the area where we're probably going to be seeing the heaviest snow. I agree with you, Carl. You know, I mean, there's nothing more beautiful, I think, than a fresh fallen snow. I mean, think about it. Your neighbor spends thousands of dollars making his beautiful weed-free lawn look gorgeous, and your yard is a mess. You haven't done anything with it. It's full of weeds. It's got all kinds of stuff on it. You put 4 inches of snow on it, and you know what? Your yard looks as good as the million-dollar mansion next door. It's a great equalizer. Love the snow out there. All right, let's get back to talking about the weather. That's my little speech about landscaping. All right. So this is where I think the heaviest snow is going to be, in that area with this winter storm warning. But I wouldn't be surprised to have an advisory coming in. All right. This is the first big change that we've had. Yesterday when we talked, I thought the snow would really kind of hold off till after midnight. Now I'm starting to think it's going to come in a little bit earlier. So it'll be light. It won't be initially a big burst of snow. I think if you have Saturday evening plans, you're comfortable driving with snow in the air, I don't think it'll be a big problem. If you're out after midnight, that could create some issues for you. So, you know, do keep an eye on that one. So we have the snow arriving in Boston about 8 o'clock tomorrow night. Central Mass and Worcester, excuse me, right around 7 o'clock or so. And then Western Mass, it's going to be coming in just a little bit sooner than that, right around 6 o'clock. So really, anytime after sunset, you're probably going to be seeing a little bit of snow in the air. Robert, I'm just trying to see your question there, but... Yeah, I mean, Robert, you know, when they issue these warnings and advisories, they will be updated. I mean, these don't even go into effect until tomorrow at 4 o'clock. So I wouldn't be surprised if those get changed. And you brought up a good point there, Robert. He's talking about, I don't know if you can see the question, but he's talking about the apps that are out there. Apps will kind of just like blurt out numbers and stuff. They're really raw. And I'm going to show you some raw computer numbers, and you'll see the discrepancy between all of these. But the thing about it is that when you have an app, it kind of looks at raw numbers and it just kind of spits it out at you. So what we do as meteorologists, we look at those raw numbers, but then we kind of take that information in and we say, okay, remember when this happened? Remember when that happened? Remember the topography, all of those things. We take that all into account. And that's why, you know, I always say your app is fine. Look at it. It's great for, you know, finding out what's going on. But if you really want to get into the details of what's happening, you know, that's when you really kind of check out the meteorologist, your favorite one, whoever it may be. I hope it's us here at Channel 5, but, you know, whoever you choose to, I think you're going to get much more definition out of that one. And you were asking for, let's see. Oh, a lot of you are asking about the snowfall totals. Ah, hi, Sarah, from near the lighthouse. I know that lighthouse really, really well. All right. So here's how much snow is going to fall across the area. And you can see the heavy stuff is going to be inland. And it really kind of like just the way you line up the roads. So from 495 west, 9 to 12. Now, is everybody going to get a foot of snow out there? No. What's going to happen is you're going to have places that are elevated above 1,500 feet, places that most of us never hear about until there's a lot of snow out there. My apologies to anyone who I offended by saying that, but that's where we're going to see the heavy snow, is where you get elevations above 1,500 feet. And then from 495 to 128, like a 6 to 9 category, into the city it gets a little more interesting, like 3 to 6, but you know, if you're right near the water, I think we're probably looking at about a 1 to 3 inch snowfall right in through there. So this is the storm that's going to cause it. I'm going to give you a rough timeline, and then we'll break it down hour by hour, and I'll show you, talk to you a little bit about more what's going on. So as the storm lifts it in, the cold air is here. This is happening tomorrow night. Snow everywhere except along the coast, and then we'll kick this storm on through here. And the thing about it is it's a fairly progressive storm, so it's not hanging around for like 2-3 tide cycles. That's why I'm not overly concerned about anything that's going to be happening in terms of coastal issues. This is not this is not like 2018, which we're on the anniversary of that actually happening yesterday. 2018, we had these incredibly high tides because tide cycle after tide cycle, the storm was just staying there. And Shannon, you're asking about the snow. Yes, inland, it will be a fluffier snow. At the coast, it's going to be a heavier snow. I don't think so, Ella. I think we're going to get a little more than 3 snowflakes out of this one. So this storm is coming in sooner. It's leaving sooner as well. And I think that's going to be kind of boding well, especially for the Patriots game, unless you are a tailgater. That could cause some issues. And then the whole thing is done with by about 11 o'clock on Sunday night, and it's clicking on out of here. And then the thing we have to really worry about is the flash freeze that follows. So liquid content, if you melted all of it down, this is how much snow we're talking about, a good inch to an inch and a half of liquid content. So if you use a 10-to-1 ratio, you can say, well, there's 8 to 12 inches of snow right there. But again, the mixing, the warming temperatures from the ocean, that ocean is 45 degrees right now. That is going to play big into this forecast. So here's a timeline. This is an hour-by-hour breakdown. I'm going to show you how it moves in. A couple things to look at. Look at the dark blue colors. That indicates where we think the heaviest snow is going to be happening at that time. And that snowfall rate at that time would be like an inch or two an hour. To give you some perspective on that, really big storms, I've seen it go up to 4 inches an hour, maybe even close to 5 inches an hour. So that's something there. So here's where we go. We're going to take a look at the timeline on this storm as it comes through. So this is tomorrow night at 7 o'clock. There might even be a little bit of ocean effect snow early in the day, kind of right at the coastline. But the main snow is out there to the west. See Pittsville at 27? Guaranteed, that's all snow. Now as it moves into Worcester, it's all snow as well. So here's your map at 11 o'clock. Boston, though, at 33 degrees and a breeze off the water, that's kind of more rain than anything else at this point. And then from there down through the coast into Plymouth, Cape and the Islands, that's all pretty much raining. As you get inland where it's cold, like Worcester and Orange at 29 degrees, that's snow. And it will be snow the whole duration. So I think the heaviest snow is going to be really from midnight till about 8 o'clock in the morning. At that time, then, you'll kind of watch the temperatures along the coast. If you live in Plymouth southward, watch what happens to the temperatures as we go deeper into the day. Out to the west, it's still snowing out there. But now the cold air starts to sink its way southward, pushing it down towards the Cape. So I think at some point on Sunday night, we're going to have a flash freeze. In other words, anything that was wet is going to freeze up. So you might have had rain all day, but now you got ice. So the crews are going to have to get out there and really work on that one as well. But notice the time on here, like 2, 3 o'clock in the afternoon. We're kind of wrapping this thing up. It doesn't mean the skies will clear and there'll still be some light snow going even into the evening hours. But really, the bulk of the moisture looks like it will be over with at that point. So I really think it's going to be the hardest hit is going to be during the morning hours, say midnight to 8 a.m. 8 a.m. to noon, that's where we're probably going to be dealing with more of a steady but lighter snow. And then steady or lighter snow. And then from noon to about 3, we're kind of tapering it all off. And after 3, it's just kind of a few spits here and there. All right, this is the time where I get to be really geeky. Because in meteorology, we love to look at computer models. And many of you do, too. I found that they're very, very popular with this storm. So I'm glad I could share them with you. I want to give you some insight into the computer models. We're going to look at some global models. We're going to look at some high-res models. And for those of you who are not into models, you can take a little pause and go to the bathroom or check out what's in the refrigerator or see what's on TV. I'm not even sure what's on TV tonight. Last night was The Golden Bachelor. Lots of people watched that one, I know. All right, so anyhow, back to the maps. We have two computer models that I really watch a lot. And these are long-range models. They're global models. That's the European and the GFS. If you were watching this week, you saw how they were different. And then as we get closer and closer to the event, see how they get to be a little more consistent with each other. Heavier snow inland, more at the coast, or less at the coast with a rain coming in there. So those were the things that I was watching for, and those are the things we got. So when I look at these computer models, I really like the way the European is set up. Now, we have entered the time period where we get what we call our high-resolution models. Now, these models don't run the distance. They run, you know, anywhere between, some of them are only 12 hours long, some of them are 72 hours long, but what it does is it gives a bigger sampling. More data is coming in. So it really gives us a better idea of what's happening. And they should be better than the global models, which are dealing with the whole world. This is dealing really with just our area. And these run all the time. So they're running, some of them are running every hour. Some of them are running every 4 hours. But I can look at these models then, and I can really kind of get an idea of, all right, is the European right? Is the European wrong? What do I need to look at? And I have two models I look at here. The NAM, which is a U.S. model as well. These are both U.S. models. And then the IBM graph model, which used to be, for some of you who are into modeling, used to be the RPM model that we used to have. I really like the RPM, but it went away. But you'll notice the trend here is that both are showing the same trend. Rain down toward the Cape with lesser amounts of snow, more heavy snow as you look inland. I like the way the IBM graph is really showing up there. That's really kind of almost what I'm thinking there in terms of totals. It may be underdoing some of the snow, like out at Orange. There's always going to be little pockets and things like that that develop. But so I'm feeling very comfortable is what I'm trying to say with the forecast that we have, just based on not only our global models, but also these high-resolution models that are coming in. So that's why I say, you know, I'm kind of keeping an eye on that graph model right now. I like the way it's setting up. I think it's underdoing the snow maybe in Orange and Keene a little bit, and maybe overdoing a little bit in Fitchburg and Lawrence. But then, you know, in Boston, yeah, a couple of 3 inches seems about right. But it also depends on what part of the city you're on. If you're in Winthrop or Eastie, it's going to be less than if you're, say, out towards even like Brookline. There'll be a distance between those two. So when I put it all together, here's what I'm thinking for snowfall totals. Let's focus in a little bit on Boston. This is what I was saying. Like Hull, for example, is going to probably have, you know, 3 inches of snow at best. And then once you get downtown, maybe 3 inches of snow, head out towards 128, probably around 6 inches of snow. I think I had a question there. Somebody was asking about Natick, but you know, you kind of put it in the 3 to 6 category there. Now, beyond 128 and 495, now we're starting to talk about, you know, where we could go that 6 to 9 inch category. And then beyond that, that's where I think we'll see our heaviest snow, because there'll be a lighter snow, a fluffier snow. Has to do with the temperatures. It'll be colder out there. You have a little more elevation as well. So to the North Shore, I mean, Cape Ann, 1 to 3, and you're going to be dealing with some mixing rain and snow and kind of slushy, ugly mess. As you get over towards like Beverly, the snowfall picks up maybe to around 3 inches of snow. You get out towards, you know, towards Lowell, you're probably getting close to 6 inches of snow. And then, you know, Nashua may be getting there like 7 or 8 inches of snow as well. And down to the Cape, as I mentioned, this is the area where we may not get much snow until the very end. And so it may not even be that much that we're talking about. So maybe like 1 to 3 inches of snow. But here I'm more concerned about the flash freeze than anything else. We're going to have a lot of water out there, and then it freezes up as we look at Sunday night as well. So those are kind of the numbers that I'm looking at. And of course, as I mentioned, out through 495, this is 9 to 12. Now, everybody always looks at the high number on here. Don't look at the high number. It's a range for a reason. 12 inches, that's really reserved for people who are living in higher elevations. And you have a little bit more colder air, and that snow will pile up a little bit more. Areas that are a little bit lower, 9 inches. I mean, even the city of Worcester, you know, we have crews that go out there all the time and take a look at it. You go to Worcester, and the difference between, you know, one of the hills and one of the valleys sometimes can be several inches of snow. And so that's why I say, you know, the 12 inches is not for everybody. But if you have a little elevation, that might be the one that we kind of have the higher totals at with that 12 inches of snow. So that's kind of what I'm thinking here. And I showed you the computer models, kind of give me an idea of where I'm going to go with it. And some of you are asking about, you know, is this an easy snow to shovel? Is it not? you know, it's going to be a fluffier snow out to the west. It's still a pretty wet snow, but it's going to be fluffier. You get into the city, it's going to be a wet snow. You get down toward the Cape, if you get snow, it's going to be more of a rain. So, you know, like somebody, Brockton, it's going to be that real, it's going to be a slurpy mess, you know, is what it looks like. So it's going to be really hard to shovel out of the way, and it weighs a lot because it's all loaded up. But I do want to recommend to you that you really kind of get out there and maybe move it on Sunday night, because Monday morning, the temperatures are really going to be dropping off pretty dramatically. And that's why I think flash freeze and also this stuff will just freeze up quite a bit. We do have a warming trend coming in the middle of next week, but it's one of those things I would say, get out there and move it if you can. So to kind of summarize everything, snow begins after sunset tomorrow. Heaviest is going to be from midnight to 8 a.m. Steady but lighter snow until about noon, and then it tapers off by about 3 o'clock into the afternoon as this whole thing moves through. And this is the thing I was talking about. Sunday night into Monday, the lows are going to drop off dramatically, and they're going to drop into the teens. So that's why I'm concerned about a flash freeze on Sunday night. So be careful about that. Especially remember, the crews can't salt while it's raining yet. They have to wait till it stops, and what you think is rain may actually be ice at some point. So that's why, you know, ice on the roads can be a real concern. And I think the biggest concern would be over Southeast Mass and over the Cape. So those are the areas that we have to keep an eye on. Hi, Susan, how are you? So there's the storm coming in, and all the stuff I've told you now, you can just kind of see it on the big picture. You'll see how it comes in. There's the snow. There's the rain at the Cape. There's the rain along the coast. Everyone goes to snow eventually. The whole thing pulls away. Here is Sunday morning. That's the heart of the storm, and it's gone then. Now, the winds are going to ramp up. This is not as strong as those winds we went through that last storm. Wow, those winds were horrible. And 80, 90-mile-an-hour wind gusts up there at Blue Hill. These will be gusting 40 to 50, mainly over the Cape. Inland areas, 20 to 30. That's not enough to really reduce visibility, so I'm not worried about blizzard conditions or anything like that, even though you're going to be getting most of the snow. And this, the strongest winds on this look like they'll be from about 9 o'clock in the morning until after sunset. And then they should back off just a little bit as well.